RAM is more reliable, especially in high-speed machines where the acceleration could exceed gravity. Now, to make it more compact, we can have this whole graph wrapped around a circle.
Hello. So everyone has watched those videos. I've played it here for your convenience as well. And I have shared the links to those original videos as well on your WhatsApp group. Everyone back after watching it? Please confirm.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So that was the introduction part, which is the theory. And you will get a lot of questions on the theory part as well. You may be asked to classify the types of followers, classify the types of cams, and you may be asked the various terms that are used in the geometry of the cams, like the pressure angle, pitch circle, base circle, pitch curve, trace point, fine. So all these are the different terms which define various parts of the geometry in cams, fine. So you may be asked about all these as a part of the theory. Now, one question definitely comes from the drawing part. So in the drawing part, what you have to do is you have to generate the cam profile. You have to generate the cam profile. Okay, so let's go ahead and see one simple example of this type. Okay, so I'll be using AutoCAD to draw this. I will be using AutoCAD, but of course in the exam or for doing assignment, you will not be having access to the software. You will have to use your drawing instruments, and using those instruments, you have to generate your diagram. So AutoCAD is loading. So here is our problem. Before going for the problem, let me just explain to you briefly, how do we get the different profiles? So all in all, we had talked about the four profiles, and we will see all those four profiles, how to generate those four profiles. Right. So let me first note down these profiles. So what was the first one? First one was constant
pitch curve.
Constant velocity, isn't it? First one was constant velocity, right? Second one, constant acceleration. So this one is also called as parabolic. This one is also called as parabolic. Fine. Third one, simple harmonic motion. Simple harmonic motion. And the last one is cycloidal. Cycloidal motion. Fine. So all these types of motions we have to study under this subject. Fine. So first let us understand how to draw the displacement diagram for constant velocity. Displacement diagram for constant velocity. Okay. Here I will draw the diagram, displacement diagram for constant velocity. So the first thing we have to take is the maximum displacement in y direction. First we have to take maximum displacement in y direction, and along the x axis we have to take the angle for which the cam will rise. The angle for which the cam will rise. So depending on the angle, you can take it proportionately. Fine. So okay, 100 is very, very small over here. Let me take something like 400. Okay, so let us say this is the maximum height that it is reaching, and angle, the maximum angle that it is turning, when for the rise to happen, that may be display, that may be shown in x axis. That may be shown in x axis. Next, I just have to draw a horizontal line from the top and a vertical line from here. Okay, and we need the intersection of these two. Okay, so this rectangle we should get first. Once we get the rectangle, we have to next divide this line into fixed number of parts. We have to divide this line into fixed number of parts. Usually we take six parts. Usually we take six equal parts. So you can see five points have been placed here, but the number of segments that the line has been divided into are six. So let me just draw vertical lines through all these points. So you can use the drafter or the roller scale. I've been telling you to get a roller scale. So we can just you can just keep the roller scale parallel to one line, then go on rolling it to get parallel lines passing through whatever points you want. So once we get this, we just take a line, join this corner with the top corner. That's it. Constant velocity diagram is drawn like this. Fine. So from the starting angle to the ending angle, the follower is rising from the base circle, which is represented by this line, to the highest point, which is represented by this line. Fine. So the intermediary displacements are obtained by these lines, these displacements. Okay. So this is how we draw the constant velocity graph. Next, let us see how to draw the constant acceleration or parabolic curve. So once again, I'll just go ahead and take this rectangle. Now the construction is going to be slightly different. So what I have to do is, I have to take the middle line, and I have to take same number of divisions on this line. I'll take six, and this center midline, six. Fine. So you can see I have divided this bottom horizontal line into six parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Same way, I have made six parts in the vertical direction also. Now what I have to do is I have to join this point with this point. Fine. And as the name itself implies, the curve that we obtain in this diagram, this displacement diagram, is parabolic. It is parabolic. Fine. So you have already learned how to draw a parabola when rectangular shape is given to us, right? You have done that in graphics, engineering graphics. So these points I have to join here, and I have to join here, and I have to draw vertical lines. I have to draw vertical lines passing through all the divisions. Okay. Now, the intersection of first line, first horizontal line and vertical line is here. This is where our parabola will start. The second line and this vertical line, their intersection gives us the second point. Same way, third line and the third vertical line gives us third point. Then the point will come here. So what I'm drawing over here, this point to this point. So what I'm getting here, this is nothing but a parabola. Fine. So let me just make these lines light so that, okay. So all these lines are just used for construction. So I'm just making them as axis lines. Fine. So this curve is a parabola. Now, when the follower is rising on this parabolic surface, what will happen is it will accelerate. That means the velocity will increase from zero to a maximum value. Fine. Now, what we have to do on the other half? What should we do on the other half? Anyone? What should we do on the other half? The other half, we have to draw another parabola, and that parabola should be decelerating parabola. Fine. So once again, I will take line, join this, this, and this. Once again, this is just for construction purpose. So I'll just convert it like this. Fine. Now our parabola will continue passing through these points till it reaches here. So I'll just remove this parabola. I'll take spline command. Okay, so this is how we create the parabola. Fine. So this is the displacement graph for constant acceleration, and it is equal to two parabolas. Fine. So the first parabola is inverted, and it results in increase of velocity at constant acceleration. The second half is a straight parabola, and this one results in deceleration. So the velocity changes from maximum value over here to zero at this end. Okay, let us see how to build this one next. So once again, the outer boundary will remain the same. Let's just copy this over here. And now we have to use simple harmonic motion. We have to build the displacement graph for simple harmonic motion. So to draw simple harmonic motion, we first have to create a semicircle over here. We have to draw a semicircle over here. So this line, we have to use it as diameter. So whatever height is given in the problem, we have to take half of it as radius of the circle, and we just need to draw half of the circle. We don't have to draw full circle. Fine. Only this part we need. This part is what we need. Now, this circle and this line, they have to be divided into same number of equal parts. Same number of equal parts. So once again, we will go ahead and take six parts. So I will divide, make six parts over here, and six parts on the semicircle. So now that these parts have been created, so of course you will not have access to the commands from AutoCAD. So what you have to do, how can you make six equal parts in the semicircle? You have to use protractor. So the total angle here is 180 degrees. The 180 degrees divided by 6 you have to do, which gives you an angle of how much? 30 degrees each. So angle between any two lines here is 30 degrees. Give me a minute. Okay, fine. So let's continue here. So understood. So we have to take angles of 30 degree each over here. By doing that, we will get six equal divisions. Then we have to take whatever length we have taken here, that length again we have to divide into six equal parts. So suppose you take 60 mm as the horizontal length, 10 mm gaps you can take. Next, just have to draw vertical lines passing from all these divisions. I just have to draw vertical lines passing through all these divisions. And then now comes the part where you will get points on these lines. Fine. So what we have to do is we have to take a horizontal line from this point till the first line, then the next point up to the next vertical line, the next one, it's actually here, fine, from there to the next line. So you should go on doing the same. You should go on doing the same. Fine. Like this, you will get 4 points, 5 points in the middle. 5 points in the middle. Fine. Next, I'll just get this line. And we have to just join all these points that we obtained using a smooth curve. Using a smooth curve. Okay. So this curve that we obtained is called as simple harmonic curve. Fine. So it is the displacement curve for the simple harmonic motion. Simple harmonic motion. Fine. And then the last one, this is the cycloidal motion. Cycloidal motion. Cycloidal motion graph is the most complicated one. Cycloidal motion graph is the most complicated motion. Fine. So watch this carefully, or else you'll get confused. So let me take the same rectangle, same height and horizontal length also I'm taking same as before. Now, what I have to do is, I should know what is the height here. What is the height here? I should know it. Fine. So here you can see the height is 80. The height is 80. So next, what we have to do is we have to find the circle. We have to find a circle for which circumference is 80. We have to find a circle for which circumference is 80. How to find that? How to find that?
2 pi r.
2 pi r, right?
Or pi d.
Pi into d, yeah. So let us find the diameter, okay. So 2 pi r should be equal to 80. So, or we can just call it as pi into d. If you want diameter, then you can use pi into d, fine. So radius will be 80 divided by 2 pi. 80 divided by 2 pi. So what do we get? Okay, let's find it. So 80 divided by 2 by pi. So that we are getting it as 12.73. Okay. So this is the calculation we have to do. This is the calculation we have to do. Now, using this 12.73, we have to draw a circle. Using that 12.73, we have to draw a circle. And that circle must be drawn on this line. That circle must be drawn on this line. Fine. Okay. What is that length then? So I'll just increase the length slightly like this. And on this line extended, I will draw the circle of this radius. Radius I have to take 12.73. Fine. So you can just round it off to 13 mm. You can just round it off to 13 mm. So take 13 mm as radius and draw it like this. Fine. Once again, all this is just for construction purpose. All this is just for construction purpose. Next, we have to divide this full circle and this horizontal line into same number of parts. Into same number of parts. Okay. So how to do that? So I have to take array polar. So in fact, here we have to take 12 divisions. On the circle, we have to take 12 divisions. Fine. instead of 6, we have to take 12 divisions on the circle. And let us understand how to get the points first. Okay. So after taking this, we have to draw lines like this. In fact, you can just draw half the circle also. That is also enough. Just draw half the circle. Okay. So we have to draw it like this, and we have to get these points. So these points are important for us. Okay. So once you get these points, on this line also we have to make the same divisions. So I'll just use the command divide. Six divisions I have taken. Then let me draw vertical lines passing through all these. Then we have to draw lines parallel to this inclined line, passing through all these points. Fine. Let me take copy. So for drawing parallel lines, you have to use ruler scale. Okay. So like this, you will get lines. Now, intersection of first vertical line and first inclined line, we have to get that. So the point is here. Then second inclined line, second vertical line, their intersection is next. The middle line and the middle line, their intersection is next. So go on doing it. Fine. So this line and this line, their intersection we have to mark next. And finally, this line and the vertical line, mark their intersection here. Okay. So we got a total of 5 points in the middle, and of course it will pass through the corners of the rectangle also. So let me now take the spline, the smooth curve, and I have to draw a spline, the smooth curve, passing through all these points. Okay, so this curve that we obtained just now, this curve is called as cycloidal curve. Okay. So these are the different curves that we are supposed to use in the CAM profile. So you should be very good with drawing these things. In the next class, we will take up some problems wherein we will be provided the height by which the follower has to rise, and the angle by which the cam will rotate during this rise. Fine. So these two will be given to us. So using those two, we first have to build these diagrams, and using the values from these diagrams, we have to build the cam profile. So that is something we will take up in the next class. So any doubts with what we just now saw? Any doubts here? Constant velocity, constant acceleration, simple harmonic, and cycloidal. You have any doubts with this?
Sir, in constant acceleration.
Yes.
Means you said in constant acceleration, the body will decelerate after it reaches a highest point or something. Saying it is constant acceleration.
Yeah, acceleration is constant. Here, the acceleration value is constant. Fine. The magnitude of acceleration and deceleration, they are both same. Are you getting it? So only thing is the sign will change from positive to negative. It will change. That's it. But the value of acceleration will be same. Okay. Have I cleared your doubt?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the construction steps are clear now? cycloidal, simple harmonic, constant acceleration or parabolic, and constant velocity. We still have 20 minutes. Shall we take up a simple problem? Okay. So let's take this problem over here. Okay, now done the question. Draw the profile of a cam operating a knife edge over having a lift of 30 mm. The cam rises the follower 6 mm for 150 degrees. 150 degrees of the rotation. Followed by a period of dwell. What is dwell? What is dwell?
Path where follower is constant.
Yeah, the follower will not move during dwell. Dwell is that period for which follower doesn't move. Follower remains at rest. So the follower descends for the next 100 degrees. And with uniform velocity. Again followed by a 12. The cam rotates. Achha, rotation and all. Cam has a least radius of 20 mm. Okay, so take this question. Everyone note this down. So this is the question we will solve. Everyone taken. So we have a cam operating a knife edge follower and it has a maximum lift of 30 mm. The cam rises the follower with SHM for 150 degrees of rotation. That is followed by a period of dwell for 60 degrees. Then the follower descends for the next 100 degrees of rotation with uniform velocity. And that is again followed by dwell. That is again followed by dwell period for the remaining rotation. Fine. The cam has a least radius of 20 mm. The cam has a least radius of 20 mm. Okay. So first, as usual, we'll have to draw the displacement diagram. So what should be the height taken? What should be the height? Is the maximum lift. The maximum lift we need here is how much? That is 30 mm. The maximum lift we need here is 30 mm. Okay. This height here is 30 mm. Okay. And then let's take a length of 60. Let's take a length of 60, then some gap, whatever length you want, and again 60. Then let us complete this rectangle. Okay. Now, this rectangle, this part, the rectangle between these two lines, we will use to plot the rise. We will use to plot the rise of the follower. Okay. So, fine. So this we will use for the rise. This 30 mm will be just for dwell. This will be just for dwell. And this part we will use for lowering. This part we will use for lowering. Fine. So look at the question and tell me, how is it getting lowered? Increase the size a little. How is it rising? With what kind of motion is it rising? You can see here, SHM. It is rising.
Simple harmonic motion.
Yeah, SHM. So how to do the SHM? You have to take a circle with half of the radius. Only half of the circle we need. Then we need to divide the circle and the line into same number of parts. Done. Next, we have to draw vertical lines through each point of the division. Next, what to do? From first point on the first line, from the second point on the second line, and so on. We have to continue doing that. Okay. So all this is just for construction purpose. All this is just for construction purpose. So let me reduce their thickness. Fine, like this. Now, this curve we have to draw dark. This curve we have to draw dark. So this curve is for SHM, simple harmonic motion. Now from this line to this line, it is dwelling. From this line to this line, it is dwelling. So dwelling means it will remain at same height. It will remain at same height. Next, from this line to this line, it is coming down. From this line to this line, it is coming down. So once again, let us divide this into how many parts you want to make. Actually, the angle given here is 100. Angle given here is 100 degrees. So if you make six equal parts, then there will be a problem. If you make six equal parts, there will be a problem. So instead of six equal parts, let us take five equal parts here. Fine, five equal parts. So how you should decide that is based on the given values. The rise was happening for 150 degrees. 150 by six, you are getting 25 degrees. You can easily mark it with a protractor. But 100 degrees, if you divide by six parts, you are getting 16.67. So these angles are very difficult to mark with the protractor. So it's better option if you divide this into five parts. So we're getting 20. Okay, we're getting 20 here. So let me divide this into five parts. And then through each of these parts, vertical line. Okay. And the constant velocity, it is coming down with uniform velocity. You can see here. It's coming down with uniform velocity. And for uniform velocity, we just have to draw a straight line. So this curve is giving us the displacement of the follower at different points. Fine. Now, using this displacement curve, we have to generate the cam profile. Okay, so now look at the question again and tell me, what is the smallest circle of the cam? What is the base circle radius. So you can see here in the last sentence, he has told the cam has least radius of 20 mm. The cam has least radius of 20 mm. So we have to take that circle. Okay. So let me draw a circle here. And radius, how much I should take? Radius, I should take 20. So this circle that I have drawn here is the base circle. The circle that I have drawn here is the base circle. Now, this is the starting point. This is the starting point. Fine. This is where the follower starts getting lifted. This is where the follower starts getting lifted. Okay. So this is our follower. This is our follower. Okay. So this here is our follower. From this point, it starts lifting. And the lift is occurring for what angle? The rise is happening for 150 degrees. The rise is happening for 150 degrees. Fine. So, okay. From here, I have to take an angle of 150 degrees. Fine. So, in anti-clockwise direction, 150 degrees. Fine. So, this angle that I obtained here is 150 degrees. So for this 150 degrees, the follower will rise from the minimum position to the maximum position. From minimum position to the maximum position. And then, once again, look at the question. And for how much angle there is a dwell? The dwell is for 60 degrees. The dwell is for 60 degrees. Once again, you have to use protractor. Take this line as the starting line, and from this line we have to take an angle of 60 degrees. So this angle here is 60 degrees. Okay. So it will rise from this line to this line, then it will remain at same position from this line to this line, and then it will come down. So in what angle is it coming down? In how much angle is it coming down?
100 degrees.
100 degrees, fine. So from here, you have to again take protractor. Take the protractor. From here, take 100 degrees. So this angle here is 100 degrees. Is this clear? So this is the first thing we have to do. This is the first thing we have to do. Okay. Next, we have to divide this 150 into equal parts. We have to divide this 150 into equal parts. Fine. So 150 into 6 parts we want to divide. So what do we get? 150 by 6, we get 25. So at 25 degree distances, we have to take the lines, right? So go on taking the lines at 25 degrees. Fine. So I have to give minus 25 here. You have to use protractor, okay? You have to use protractor. I'm using the commands directly. But you have to mark all these lines using the protractor. Okay, so now we got the 6 equal divisions here. We got the 6 equal divisions over here. Next, what we have to do, we have to take the displacements here in this diagram, and we have to mark that displacement here. We have to mark that displacement here. So I don't have a compass in AutoCAD, so I will just take a circle. I'll just take a circle. Fine. So this is the length I want to transfer. So this is circle of radius, which is equal to this displacement. And the same displacement I want to take here. Okay. And I will mark this point. So the gap between this point and the center of circle is the same as the gap between this point and the curve, isn't it? So the same way you have to use compass, same way you have to use compass to take this measurement, transfer it here. Transfer it here. Fine. So go on doing that. Next line. This is the measurement. On next line, we have to mark it. Then again, take that. This one is over. Next is this. Go on taking it. Go on transferring these measurements like this. Fine. Again and again, I'm telling you, you have to use your instruments. You have to use your instruments on pen, instruments and pencil. And on the drawing sheet, you have to draw all this. If the line is smaller, you have to extend it and take the intersection. And the last one is here. So last one here. You can see the line is not touching. So what I have to do, I have to extend the line till it touches, and that intersection point I have to take. Okay. So the work of this circle is over. Let me delete it. So that circle, I used it just the way you use your compass. Just the way you use your compass. Fine. Now we got 6 points here. All these 6 points you have to join using a smooth curve. So take a smooth curve passing through all these points. Okay. Or is it? I think I forgot to start the recording for this. Anyway, I started it just now. Since, is it? Yeah. Fine. Now from this line to this line, the follower has to remain stationary. How is that possible? Just take a circle with this point as center, passing through this up to this. So we only need the arc between those two lines. Fine. So this is how we got the cam profile up to here. After this, we have to take angle difference of 20 degrees. Fine. After this, we have to take 20. So copy. Doing this fast. I hope by now you understood how I'm taking this. You just have to use protractor, 20 degrees difference. You have to take all this. And then you must go on taking these lengths, transfer them over here. So all these measurements we are marking from the base circle. Please keep that in mind, okay? The last point will be here at this intersection. Okay. So I just need to draw a spline passing through all these points. That's it. This is my cam profile. Okay. So this circle may be just left as, you know, not that dark, and only the cam profile should be made dark. Okay. Hope you have understood this. A lot of other problems also similar to this we will have to solve. They will take different kind of motion and they will give a different base radius, different angles, and the similar procedure you have to follow. First you have to create the displacement diagram, then transfer all these lengths onto the cam and get the cam profile. Okay. So unfortunately I couldn't record this. I forgot to start the recording for this particular class.
Sir, in Teams it's already recorded.
Okay, Teams, someone has started recording? Fine, if you have started
yes,
recording
sir.
In the Teams, then it's okay. On the YouTube, I forgot to start. I forgot to press that button. Anyway, it's okay. So, fine. So that's it for this class. In next class, we will just take up some more problems like this. We will take one for, you know, roller follower. Then we'll take another for oscillating follower and all. And let us see. Okay. Any doubts for today's class? Any doubts for today's class?
So while drawing the displacement diagram, the horizontal distance can be anything, sir.
Yes, it can be anything. In some textbooks, they take it proportional to the angle, but with experience, I have found that it's not necessary. You can take whatever length you wish, and still our path is going to be the same. Path will end up always the same. Okay. Any other doubts? Yeah, any other doubts? Any other doubts? Fine then. I'm stopping this class. Recording has been stopped. I'm stopping the recording.